The ancient oceans were home to some of the most terrifying creatures to ever roam the earth. From giant sharks to massive squid, the waters were full of beasts that could make even the bravest sailor tremble with fear. This beastly marine reptile was a member of a group of large, predatory creatures known as mosasaurs. They lived during the Late Cretaceous period and were closely related to modern-day snakes and monitor lizards. This particular mosasaur genus lived in the western interior seaway, a vast body of water that cut through what is now present-day North America. Although there were other predators in the seaway, this particular species was undoubtedly one of the largest and most powerful. But who was this fierce predator, and what do we know about its life and behavior? Join me as we dive deeper into the world of this ancient marine reptile and discover the fascinating story of Tylosaurus, a giant marine reptile that lived during the Late Cretaceous period about 85 million years ago. Unlike other mosasaurs, this creature did not have teeth at the end of its snout or on the bony protuberance that was the rostrum. Scientists believe that this feature was used primarily for ramming and other combative purposes, giving Tylosaurus an advantage in the fight for survival. The broad and somewhat rectangular internarial bar of its skull provided high cranial stability and resistance to stress forces, making it an even more formidable opponent. And while some might think that the elongated rostrum was developed as a function of sexual behavior, the fact that it was present in infant Tylosaurus rules out this possibility. In addition to its unique rostrum, it was also known for its impressive array of teeth. With 24 to 26 teeth in the upper jaw, 20 to 22 teeth on the palate, and 26 teeth in the lower jaw, this creature was well equipped to capture and devour its prey. And with 29 to 30 vertebrae between the skull and hip, 6 to 7 vertebrae in the hip, and 33 to 34 vertebrae in the tail with chevrons, it had an incredibly flexible and agile body, allowing it to navigate the treacherous waters of the western interior seaway with ease. All in all, it was an impressive and intimidating creature, feared by all who encountered it in the ancient seas. Its length was 12 to 15.8 meters. That's right, my friends, we're talking about a marine reptile that could rival the size of a school bus. Meet Bunker, the largest known Tylosaurus specimen, proudly showcased at the University of Kansas Natural History Museum. It's a testament to the sheer magnitude this creature could achieve. It didn't simply adhere to the status quo, it exemplified Cope's rule, evolving to become even larger over time. During its early days in the Turonian and Carnesian epochs, it roamed the waters at a still impressive 5 to 7 meters in length, weighing between 200 to 500 kilograms. But as the Santonian period rolled in, they took its size to new heights, reaching lengths of 8 to 9 meters and tipping the scales at around 1.1 to 1.8 metric tons. While we can only dream of the possibilities, paleontologist Mike Everhart speculates that in some remote corner of the ancient seas, a mythical Tylosaurus measuring a mind-boggling 20 meters, 66 feet in length, might have roamed. Alas, no evidence has surfaced to confirm this magnificent claim, leaving it as a tantalizing possibility lingering in our imaginations. Its classification and evolutionary history are no less fascinating. As a member of the superfamily Mosasauridae, it is part of the family Mosasauridae, a group of large aquatic reptiles. It was one of the earliest known derived mosasaurs, with the oldest fossil attributed to the genus dating back to around 85 million years ago. Currently, scientists recognize 8 species of Tylosaurus as taxonomically valid, including T. prorigor, T. nepalucus, T. bernardi, T. gaudri, T. eviensis, T. iambensis, T. membanensis, and T. saskanawanensis. However, the validity of 2 additional taxa remains unsettled, and there is still a debate among researchers about whether T. kanzensis is synonymous with T. nepalucus. It was a true monster of the sea, and its diet was as fierce as its appearance. As a top predator, it ruled the oceans of the Late Cretaceous period, feasting on anything it could catch. With a massive head and powerful jaws, it was capable of swallowing medium-sized animals whole, and its teeth were not designed for chewing prey. Instead, it tore its prey apart and swallowed the pieces, much like modern-day snakes and monitor lizards. Feeding on fish, seabirds, and other marine reptiles like the plesiosaurs and other mosasaurs, the Tylosaurus was an agile hunter, swimming at high speeds to catch its prey. Its diet also included sharks, giant squids, turtles, and other marine reptiles, making it a fierce competitor for food. Despite its massive size, there is no evidence to suggest that it preyed on dinosaurs, although it might have scavenged on their remains. It reigned supreme in the ancient seas, using its lightning-fast swimming abilities to catch and devour anything that crossed its path. One of the biggest threats to them was other predators. In the oceans of the Late Cretaceous, there were a variety of large, toothy creatures that would have been more than happy to make a meal out of a Tylosaurus. These included other mosasaurs as well as sharks and predatory fish. Even the occasional pterosaur or dinosaur could pose a threat if it ventured too far out into the water. But despite this danger, it was also well adapted to its habitat. It lived in warm, shallow seas that were teeming with life, and it was able to thrive in this environment thanks to its powerful jaws and sharp teeth. The discovery of their fossils came at a controversial period in paleontologic history known as the Bone Wars. This was a period of fierce rivalry between the most prominent paleontologists of the 19th century, notably Edward Drinker Cope and Othniel Charles Marsh. Thus, the naming history of the members of this genus is a bit messy. Paleontologists found the first Tylosaurus specimen in Kansas in 1868. It was the specimen of a skull and vertebrae. Edward Cope gave these fossils the name Macrosaurus preauger and put them in the Leodon genus. In 1872, Othniel Marsh discovered a more complete specimen and named it Rhinoceros, also known as nose lizard. However, the name and the replacement he chose were already in use by another animal. Eventually, he had to settle for the name Tylosaurus, also known as knob lizard. Although many fossils associated with the Tylosaurus genus have been discovered in central United States and Canada, paleontologists now think many of these discoveries are not actual Tylosaurus. Rather, they belong to other older species in the mosasaurid family. Moving on to their demise, Tylosaurus and its fellow mosasaurs started to become extinct during the KT extinction event. This catastrophic event, which occurred at the end of the Cretaceous period, wiped out not only the mosasaurs, but also all non-avian dinosaurs. Scientists believe that the KT extinction was triggered by a massive asteroid impact that caused widespread fires, tsunamis, and a global cooling effect. The resulting environmental changes were catastrophic for many species, including the mosasaurs, whose populations began to decline rapidly. The extinction of these apex predators had a profound impact on the marine ecosystem and allowed other groups of marine reptiles, such as the plesiosaurs, to flourish in their absence. This massive marine reptile has also been featured in documentaries like the 2021 BBC documentary series Walking with Dinosaurs. It appears on various video games, including the popular Jurassic Park franchise. In the game, Jurassic World Evolution, players can create their own aquatic exhibit and feature Tylosaurus as one of the star attractions. And it also came to be visible in a few Hollywood films like Sea Monsters: A Prehistoric Adventure, Prehistoric Monsters Revealed, etc. Overall, while Tylosaurus may not have the same level of pop culture fame as some of its dinosaur counterparts, it is still a fascinating and impressive creature that has left its mark in various forms of media. And if you're into cool stuff like this, make sure to click on the like and subscribe buttons below. By learning about Tylosaurus and other prehistoric animals, we get a better idea of just how diverse and complicated life on Earth really is. And if you're curious about other prehistoric animals and want to know more about them, then you should definitely click the video on your screen right now. We'll tell you everything you need to know about this fascinating topic and help you deepen your understanding of these incredible creatures.